happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you fine, wanna have a good time, then like, comment, and subscribe. Hey y'all, it's Miss Tosh Tosh, aka Natasha, back again with another video. So, today, we're gonna be talking about why these pageants need to stop playing with our emotions. And I say this because recently I've encountered a situation where pageants don't follow through on their promises. And what I mean by that is that most pageant systems have a prize package. Now, the bigger the pageant system, the bigger the prize package. But sometimes pageant systems don't fulfill on their prize package and the stuff that they promise. A lot of these systems do have contracts, and some are non-bounding, and some are binding. It means you can't compete in another pageant system until your reign for that system is up. However, some pageant systems are open, and you can compete in another pageant system as long as you notify them or let them know, or some pageants don't even care. I mean, you can compete in any system you want to. However, for those systems that do involve a contract, it's important for you, those systems that have liability for their actions and to fulfill through all the stuff that the contract offers. Now, for example, I'm not going to throw out any specific pageant systems out there, but I am going to say that I have my fair share of experiences with contracts not being followed through on the pageant side or the director side. So sometimes it's not the system, it's the director. And if the director is running the system, then it's this entire system as a whole. Me personally, I feel like if you can't afford it or if you don't have a definite answer from sponsors, you should not put them on the list. Because the title holder is already investing a lot of money and a lot of resources and time into competing in your pageant system. And it's not fair for them to consider competing in the system because of what the prize package is said to be offered. And when they don't receive that prize package, it can be a sign of betrayal. It can be a sign of defeat because a lot of us do spend a lot of money and invest in a lot of money into competing in these systems. It should be no reason why the director cannot fulfill on their side of what they promised the contestants. In my example, there's been plenty of times where the money becomes a problem. I repeat, the money becomes a problem. When I look in a pageant system, I look at the benefits. What am I getting from this system? I've been doing pageants for years now, and I'm doing pageants to where the offer is greater than the given. Basically meaning if I'm putting in a certain amount of money, I expect to either get that money back or exceed the amount that I give in prizes or in scholarship. I expect to receive something in return. So if it gets to the point where I'm over here and I'm getting all these little things, but I'm not getting the money that I expected with it, it becomes a void of contract for me, because not only is that a sign of disrespect because I am investing my time and energy, I'm representing your system, and I'm not getting, it's a job. You don't have employees and you're not going to pay them. This is not volunteer service. Actually representing a system is a job. Of course we do community service and volunteer service and we all have our platforms, but that system is not our volunteer service. That system is our job. When we're reflecting a system, that means they gave us a responsibility of being a representative, being an employee, being the face and an ambassador for that system. Therefore, we need to get something in return for that. We're not giving you free advertisement. The contestants deserve better. I am tired of systems promising us one thing and not giving us exactly what they promise. Do not put $1,000 as a winning scholarship money but don't have the money to give to your contestants. And I understand if it's a new systems, you still can't get away with that. Please avoid that now. Avoid promises that you can't keep now, because at the end of the day you have earned a lot more respect knowing that you're a new system, and as you grow and you build, then you're able to fulfill on those promises. But however, if you can't do it, you know, stick to your realm. Stick to what you can do. Like a photo shoot. A photo shoot can range between a couple hundred dollars So if you find a great photographer that's also building their business, partner up, make that your sponsor, have that photographer, you know, for a certain amount of money, be able to shoot your contestants, because at the end of the day, you're building each other's business, and you're both new, or you're both are small businesses. That'll be a great example of how to network and build your system. But if you over here expecting a big name photographer to come shoot your pageant, and you're not able to give them the mainframe and the mainstream that they want, then you are basically, the contestants are missing out on a great opportunity. It's okay to start from the bottom and make your way up. You don't have to be like Miss Universe or Miss America as soon as possible. Every system has to start from somewhere. Every system starts in one state or the other. And it's just about building. It's about getting the clout, getting the customers, and the advertisement through the great system itself. Let the system do the talking. Let the system do the work. Because I know for a fact, small pageants have now steered me into a different direction to go for more bigger systems, only because I've already have been through the problems and chaos of competing in systems and them promising us stuff that we don't get. And I'm not the type of person that's going to stop representing a system. If I win that system, then yes, I will be the best title holder I can be and still promoted, because at the end of the day, if your intentions are where it needs to be, then I will look past that and help you try to get, you know, customers, try to get girls and contestants and candidates to compete in your pageant. But if this is on purpose, or if it's something just to get money out of girls, I do not support that. I do not condone that type of activity, because we've all worked hard, and for some of us this is a passion. Some of us want to go to Miss America or go to Miss Universe and Miss International, Miss World, Miss Earth, all these great big platform pageants, and you're over here making them think that all pageant systems do this, and that's not the case. For me, I'm gravitating more towards the pageants that have more exposure, because you know they're legit. And legit not meaning that they offer you a lot of money, but they do offer you benefits, and you feel like you are getting what you paid for. Some of us spend more money than others. However, we don't feel that way after we win, because after we win, by the time it happens, we're like, oh my gosh, I get all this stuff. I'm promoting myself, my platform, what I'm passionate about, and I don't feel like I'm being gypped at all. But it's just the fact that they've earned that respect, they've earned that clout, and they've earned the opportunity to actually give girls what they deserve. And all said is done, please do not make promises that you can't keep. And that's really the whole purpose of me making this video. And I just feel like this will help out and clarify a lot. Please do your research. For those who are considering competing in smaller pageants or systems that don't really have much on their website or much on their social media or have a small follower base, please do your research and actually contact past title holders or contact other directors that have worked with the system or anybody that you think have any affiliation with the system. Just do your research, ask them what you think you should do, their experience with the person, and if all reviews are negative, I say that it's time to choose a different system to represent. But if you think it is a good investment and you want to give this smaller system a chance, then I say go ahead and go for it. But I do recommend you do your research ahead of time, so you won't be surprised like some of us veterans that have been doing this for a long time. So that is basically all I'm trying to get at, is for systems, please fulfill on your promises. And for girls, please do your research. I am begging you, so we can avoid everyone the trouble and every girl get what they deserve. That is it for today's video, guys. Thank you for tuning in. If you like me, if you like my face, if you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe so we can build it up and I can bring more content to the table. Other than that, keep it cute, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.